Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about Hall effect applications and mass action law and the Einstein relationship. So first we'll go with the applications of Hall effect. Okay, so the first point is determination of type of semiconductor. That means if suppose a semiconductor is given to us, then how you can find out whether it is a n-type semiconductor or p-type semiconductor. So we can find out or we can determine which type of semiconductor it is means by calculating the Hall voltage and Hall coefficient. Okay, so if the Hall voltage or Hall coefficient is negative, we can consider the type of material is n-type semiconductor, and if the Hall voltage is positive, then we will consider that material is the p-type semiconductor. Okay, so what the point here is, if VH, that is Hall voltage, or RH is equal to is negative, then the type of material or semiconductor is of n-type semiconductor. If VH, or that is Hall voltage or Hall coefficient, is positive. Okay, if it is positive, then that type of material is p-type semiconductor. So this is one of the application of this Hall effect. Okay, so I am giving the statement, when the Hall coefficient or the Hall coefficient or Hall voltage is negative, then the type of semiconductor is called as what? That is n-type semiconductor. If it is a positive value, so we can consider that type of material is a p-type semiconductor. So next application is calculation of carrier concentration. Okay, so in semiconductors, in conductors we have only one carrier, that is nothing but the electron. Okay, but here in semiconductors we have two types of carriers. Okay, two types of charge carriers. So we have to find out the concentration of charge carriers that is present in a semiconductor. For that one, we are going to use the Hall effect here. Okay, that is one application. Okay, so in semiconductors, the electrons and holes are the charge carriers. Okay, so we have to find out the concentration of the electron or hole, then we are going to use the Hall effect. So how you can calculate? Okay, so we already seen that the Hall coefficient is equal to 1 by NQ. Okay, so here RH is nothing but the Hall coefficient, and NQ is not, N is nothing but the electron concentration. Okay, here N is the electron concentration. Electron concentration. Similarly, we can also define the Hall coefficient in terms of hole concentration. Okay, so here 1 by NQ is, N is here the electron concentration, and if you consider this the same value, that is RH is equal to 1 by PQ. P is here the hole concentration. Okay, so in semiconductors means we have to consider both electron and hole. That's why here the equation of Hall coefficient is, we have written in terms of electron concentration and at the same time the hole concentration. But what we require from these equations is electron concentration we require. So therefore this N I am taking to this side, and therefore N is equal to 1 by RH cube. Okay, here how we can calculate the RH value? Okay, so we have derived the equation in the previous discussions that Hall coefficient is equal to Hall voltage multiplied with the thickness by BI. B is nothing but your magnetic flux density, and I is the current through the semiconductor. Okay, so from this one we are going to calculate the RH, and if I substitute that RH in this equation so that I can calculate the electron concentration. Okay, so therefore RH here is VH into T by BI. Okay, so from this equation we will calculate the RH, that means Hall coefficient, and we will substitute that Hall coefficient, this n equal to 1 by Rh into Q, so that we can get the electron concentration. Okay. Similarly, for the same value of Rh, we can also calculate the concentration of the holes in the semiconductor. So, if I substitute this Rh value, again in this equation, P is equal to 1 by Rh into Q, so that we can get the hole concentration. Here, Q is the electron charge of the electron, that is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Okay, so this is the electron charge, but electron is a negative charge, so we will consider the value as here negative. Okay, so now while calculating the value of hole concentration, we will substitute this instead of Q plus we'll substitute plus Q. That means what? The electron charge and the hole charge both will be numerically equal, but it has the opposite sign. Electrons is of negative charge and hole of positive charge. That's why the hole charge, or the charge of the hole, will be considered as plus 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Okay, so this is the point. From this equation, we can calculate the carrier concentration. Okay, now this is one of the application, and we'll move on to the third application. Okay, so we can also calculate the mobility of the charge carriers. Okay, that means here how the electrons will move, that is the mobility. What is mobility means here? Mobility characterizes how quickly an electron or hole can move through the semiconductor when we apply an electric field. Okay, so that mobility we have to calculate from the Hall effect. How you can calculate? So once again, I am giving what is mobility here. Mobility that characterizes the how quickly an electron or hole can move through a semiconductor by the application of electric field, that is given by the mobility. Okay, so here by using the Hall effect, we are going to calculate the application, that is mobility of the charge carriers. That is nothing but determination of mobility of charge carriers. Okay, so here we already derived that in the previous discussion, the conductivity of an electron. Conductivity of an electron. Okay, so what is the conductivity we have considered here? Sigma is equal to n nu e. Okay, so here n is nothing but the concentration of the charge carriers, and mu is the mobility. And we can also write, we are writing here, we are considering Q instead of charge E. That's why sigma is equal to n mu Q. N is the concentration of the charge carriers, and mu is the mobility, and Q is the charge of the charge carrier. Either it may be electron or hole. Okay, so if we are going to calculate the mobility of an electron, so we will consider the suffix as mu n. If you are going to calculate the mobility of the hole, we will substitute that mu p. Okay, so that's what the point here. But the generalized equation here, the conductivity sigma, we will indicate as that is equal to n mu q. Okay, so now I have to find out the mobility of an electron or the mobility of a hole. So for that one, I am taking this from this one. I am taking here that now n is equal to sigma by mu q. Sorry, we have to calculate mu. So mu is equal to, from this one, mu is equal to, if I send these two in this side, so that becomes sigma by n q. Okay, so what I told, this n indicates the carrier concentrations. Okay, so now we have to calculate the mobility of electron and at the same time mobility of the hole. For that one, what is the equation? So here I can extend this equation to the electron, and same time I can extend this equation to the hole mobility. Okay, here mu n is the electron mobility or mobility of the electron. Electron mobility, and mu p is here mobility of holes. So what I am doing here, I have considered the generalized conductivity equation. From that one I am writing the mobility equation. After that I am extending that one to the semiconductor. This is for generalized case, that is for the conductor, what we have discussed previously, okay, and derived the conductivity equation. That is generalized case, or we can also consider the conductivity in a conductor. Okay, so that is equal to n mu q. But here, why we are using n here is nothing but in the conductor, there is no scope of holes. Okay, only in the conductor all are electrons. So that's why we will consider the generalized equation sigma is equal to n mu q. So from that one I am writing, or I am extending that equation for the semiconductors. So we have two types of mobilities, the mobility of the electron and at the same time the mobility of the holes. So here the mobility of electron mu n is equal to sigma n by n q. Okay, so the conductivity due to the electrons and at the same time we have 1 by n q. Okay, so here sigma n, because we are calculating the electron mobility, that's why I am using sigma n here. And as it is, this one is nq. N is the electron concentration and q is the charge of the electron. Okay, now only I have given the value, that is the charge of the electron, that is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Okay, therefore from this equation we can calculate the mobility of the electron. So here how you can calculate, that means here 1 by nq is nothing but the Hall coefficient what we have considered, right? So by taking this one RH value, or by calculating the RH value, so we can easily calculate the mobility of electrons, or at the same time here mu p is mobility of the holes, that is equal to sigma p by pq. What is p here? P is nothing but the hole concentration. P is the hole concentration. So that is nothing but mu p is equal to sigma p by 1 by pq. Here I already told that the Hall coefficient can be extended for both holes and at the same time the electrons. So here already we have written in terms of electrons concentration. So I can extend that one to the hole concentration. So 1 by pq is nothing but the RH, that is Hall coefficient in terms of the holes. That is mu p, mobility of the holes, is equal to sigma p by pq, or in place of 1 by pq, if you substitute RH, so that becomes mu p is equal to RH into sigma p. This one sigma is nothing but here conductivity, RH is the Hall coefficient. So like this we can also calculate the mobility of electrons and holes. Okay, so this is the third application of Hall effect. Okay, so next we are moving with the fourth application, that is measurement of magnetic flux density. So in the Hall effect we are going to apply a magnetic field perpendicular to the current. Okay, so that means what, we have to calculate how much magnetic field or magnetic flux density that is present, that is applied perpendicular to the current carrying conductor. Okay, so to calculate that magnetic flux density, so we have here, we are going to use the Hall effect, that means Hall coefficient we are going to use. Okay, so from the previous discussion we have RH is equal to VH T by VI. Okay, RH is equal to Hall coefficient is equal to VH T by VI. From this one I am writing the magnetic flux density B is equal to, so what happened here, B I require, so this B I am taking to this side, so what happened, the B is equal to VH into T by RH into I. Here VH is Hall voltage, T is nothing but the thickness of the conductor, T is the thickness, thickness of conductor or semiconductor we can also say here, thickness of the semiconductor. So RH is Hall coefficient and I is the current that is flowing through the semiconductor. Okay, so if you know all these values you can easily calculate the magnetic flux density, that is the B is equal to VH into T by RH into I. So these are the four very important applications regarding related to semiconductors. Okay, Hall effect has many applications, but in our consideration, that is particularly in our semiconductors, we have these four applications for the Hall effect. Okay, so now we are moving with the next topic, that is mass action law. Okay, then what is mass action law here? Mass action law means at equilibrium condition, at a constant temperature, the product of hole concentration and electron concentration is equal to a constant, and that is the square of intrinsic semiconductor concentration. Okay, sorry, intrinsic carrier concentration. So I am repeating here, what is mass action law? Okay, at equilibrium condition with constant temperature, the product of electron concentration and hole concentration is a constant, and that constant is equal to the square of the intrinsic carrier concentration. Okay, so here if I consider N is the electron concentration and P is the hole concentration, according to mass action law, the product of hole electron concentration and hole concentration, that is N into P, is equal to the square of the intrinsic carrier concentration, and it is a constant. So NP is equal to Ni square here. Okay, here Ni is the intrinsic carrier concentration. Okay, so the product, that is N into P, the hole concentration and electron concentration, is equal to the square of the intrinsic carrier concentration. Okay, so that intrinsic carrier concentration equation is here, Ni is equal to B into T power 3 by 2 e power minus Eg by 2 kT. Okay, so here B is nothing but it will varies with for a specific semiconductor. Okay, and B is the coefficient value of the specific semiconductor, and it is T power 3 by 2, and T is here the temperature, and here we have Eg. What is Eg means? That is energy gap. Energy gap is nothing but, if you consider the energy band diagram, so it is the conduction band and it is the valency band. Okay, so it is valency band and it is conduction band, and the difference or the gap between the conduction band and valency band, here is we have energy gap. Energy gap we will indicate with Eg. So this indicates, or this value we will consider as Eg. Okay, so in the coming classes, so I will calculate or I will derive the equation for Eg also. Okay, so therefore here the Ni, intrinsic carrier concentration, is B into T power 3 by 2 e power minus Eg by 2 kT. Here T is the temperature, K is the Boltzmann's constant, and Eg is energy band gap. That is nothing but the gap between conduction band and valency band. Okay, so this is about the mass action law. Okay, so now we are going with the next topic, that is nothing but Einstein relationship in semiconductor. So what this equation will provide for us is, we have the mobility and at the same time the diffusion coefficient. Okay, mobility means what? Where we will get this mobility? Mobility means movement of the electron or flow of electrons. It will characterize the how quickly the electrons will flow through the, or electrons or holes will flow through the semiconductor if you apply an external electric field. So I already defined that what is external electric field means. External electric field, if you apply an external electric field, then there will be a some current flow due to the drifting of the electrons or holes. Okay, so that is nothing but the drift process what we will consider. Whenever you find out external field, so that will be a drifting of electrons. Okay, due to that the drift current will be obtained. Okay, here then why this Einstein relationship and what is its significance? Okay, so it will give us the relation between the mobility of the charge carriers, that is electrons and holes. Okay, and the diffusion constants or diffusion coefficients of the electrons and holes. Okay, so what it gives, the Einstein relationship will give the relation between the mobility and the diffusion coefficients of electrons and holes respectively. Okay, so that's what here the Einstein relationship will indicate. So the equation that relates the mobility of the electrons and holes and the diffusion coefficients of electrons, that is d suffix n and d suffix p, is known as the Einstein relationship. Okay, that is the significance. It will give the relation between the mobility and the diffusion coefficients of the electrons and holes. Okay, then how it is represented equation wise, here we have, that is dp by mu p, that is diffusion coefficient of holes by the mobility of the holes, that is equal to dn by mu n, the diffusion coefficient of electrons by the mobility of the electron, that is equal to vt, v suffix t. Then what is vt here? You all know that dp is nothing but the diffusion coefficient of holes and mu p is the mobility of the holes, and their ratio is equal to the ratio of diffusion coefficient of electrons and the mobility of the electrons, that is equal to vt. Then what is vt? Vt is here is called as voltage equivalent of the temperature. Okay, so here vt is the voltage equivalent of the temperature. Okay, so then what is vt? Vt is equal to kt by q. Here again we have the k is the Boltzmann's constant and d is the temperature and q is the charge of the carriers. Okay, right, so vt is equal to kt by q. If I substitute the k value and the electron charge, okay, so I will get t by 11,600. Okay, so this is the equation of vt. Okay, so vt is equal to what? Kt by q. Here k is the Boltzmann's constant and t is the temperature and q is the charge of the electron. Okay, so therefore it is kt by q. If we substitute the k value and q value, we will get vt is equal to t by 11,600. Okay, now at room temperature, if you substitute at room temperature, means we have 300 degree Kelvin. So if you substitute the 300 degree Kelvin here, so the vt will be, you will get is 26 millivolts. Okay, so what is this one? Voltage equivalent of temperature, that is equal to 26 millivolts at 300 degree Kelvin. Okay, so this is about the Einstein relationship in semiconductors. Okay, so that is equal to the relation between dp, mu p, dn, mu n, and that is equal to vt. Right, so this is what we have for today, that is Hall effect applications and mass action law. And another point here, the ni will varies with the temperature. You can observe here t power 3 by 2 is there. Okay, so the ni, incentric carrier concentration. Incentric means what? When we increases the temperature, there is a whole electron pair will be generated. That means the incentric carrier concentration will varies with the temperature. That's what this term will indicate. Okay, so this is about the mass action law. Next one is the Einstein relationship in semiconductors. Okay, thank you.